In this video, I will try out these pens that I got recently. They are the Sarasa gel pens in different variation of colors. And I got these two sets mostly because these are the ones that I found in my local bookshop. And I was really surprised to find these because they are Japanese pens. And it's not something that I've seen in store before. The first time I came across these pens was when I was in a trip in Japan. And initially, the first color that I got was this wine red color. I think it's called Black Red. And it quickly became one of my favorites, mostly because of the color, which shows up beautifully on paper. And also, because it writes so smoothly, it's just so nice and just glides over the paper. I always wanted to try more of these colors because, like I said, I only tried this red one. So when I saw this, I just grabbed it immediately. The paper that I usually use is also Japanese paper. I'm currently using the Midori one, and I've tried this red one in that one, and I feel like the paper is very similar because it's smooth. It just feels thicker. It doesn't feel that flimsy. I have ordered the Hobonichi one, so it will be interesting to try these on in that as well to see how they show up, because with these ones, especially this one which I've tried before, I feel like it doesn't transfer, which is great, but then the paper is also thicker. So we'll see how it goes with thinner paper in the future. I do have this red one, so I will leave this little cap on until I run out of the other one, but I'll go ahead and try these, and then I'll just get my current red one, which I haven't run out yet. And I've already tried this, which is why it's on. Basically all of these, I already tried them. It does have this clip, which is very handy for fastening it on a notebook. That's a bit handy too, because you can, and it won't break. Like, I have a bad habit of like doing this to a lot of pens and accidentally breaking them. So I guess that's a bonus that you can actually clip it like this without ruining it. Let's see how this shows up. Let's just write some, like, what. And I do have another green pen, but I do feel like this shows up more green than the other one. Just for a comparison, I will go and bring my uni-ball, which is the one that I also use. But this looks so pretty. It writes so smoothly, like it doesn't skip. Let me go ahead and grab my other pens. Here is my other green one, which is the uni-ball signo DX in 0.38. One thing I have noticed with this one is that if I write a letter, and let's say I write something, firstly, it shows up darker than this one. It's a very subtle, deep green color. If I do hold it like this for some time, like sometimes I take breaks when I'm writing, then when I go back and write more, it can make a little bit of a splotch because it has accumulated in the tip. So sometimes I have a bit of scrap paper where I just swipe it like that and then continue to write. That's just something that I have noticed when I use it for a longer period of time. But otherwise, this one is really good, really smooth, and the color is also really beautiful. So if you're looking for more of a deep mossy green color, I would recommend this. Otherwise, this vintage one shows up more on paper since it's brighter. Here's my old red one, which I bought a couple of years ago. I do use it very frequently, but still it hasn't run out yet, so it's really amazing. Let's see. I mean, there's still tons left, and I feel like I've written so much with it. I have used about half of it, like you can see. So this is an honest review. I've used these for a very long time. and I'm very happy with them. This is the red black color, and as you can see, it's so nice. This color is just, I think I just have a preference for this wine color in general with stuff, clothes, obviously this pen. It's one of my favorites, so I'm happy to have two of them now. I did have another because I did buy a backup, but I might have lost it. Here is the brown gray or brown black, I'm not sure. It shows up like this. It's just a beautiful brown. And here's in this one. I just love this color. Not sure what this is called. Like blue, gray, probably. We have the blue black. And these writes, I mean, it's so opaque. These ones are a bit more translucent, maybe this one, but this one is just very opaque. Perfect. And then I got these, which are the milk color pens. So this was more of an impulse purchase. These are also in 0.5 like the other ones. And the pen itself, like you can see, transparent instead of having this opaque plastic. I feel like these look more elegant in a way with a clip. And these ones look more fun and cute. I have tried this before and unfortunately it does skip a bit. I'm not sure if it's because it's brand new, but I suspect it's the ink itself, which is not as, I don't know, smooth, which makes it, yeah, you can see it kind of skips, which is unfortunate. I do feel like it feels drier. Maybe that's why it skips. And it doesn't feel as smooth when you run it over the paper, especially at an angle. I feel like it gets stuck and it feels like it's scratching the paper a bit. Obviously, I won't try much of this white one. It doesn't really show up on paper, but I think this will be fun to try on brown paper when I write letters or for decoration on colored paper. We have this peachy orange one, which looks really nice, but like the other one, it does skip. I don't know what's with these pens that makes it do that. It does look nice though when it actually works. This pink one. Yeah, I feel like this one might skip even more than the other ones. Like it looks really choppy in some areas. I have tried the blue one the most because I used it in my diary for about 3 pages and it was okay. Actually, I take it back. I did try this one in my diary as well for about 1/2 a page and it was worse than the other ones. Like you can see, it skips so much. Even if I try it in different angles, it's just... I kind of am not happy with these. I do prefer the vintage ones. Like you can see here, they just write so nicely. The colors are beautiful and they never skip on me. Whereas these brighter ones, they just don't feel as satisfying to write with. And if there's something that I hate, is a pen skipping on me, because I lose patience so fast. Because it ruins the page. It looks very messy and just not nice. So I guess this was my not really, I mean, kind of review, but also try on of these milk pens, and then also the Sarasa clip vintage ones. I recommend this one. It's perfect, great to write with, show up beautifully on paper. And yeah, so that's it for today. I might make more videos in the future. I'm not usually one to make videos like this, but I did feel like it would be fun to try this out. So yeah, I hope you, whoever is watching this, is having a great day, and I'll see you next time.